Once again, the Jewett, Klopfenstein, and Things program takes great pride in presenting to you that foremost author, world-renowned lecturer, writer of many books, musical director, singer, actor, producer, and water boy for the Cucamonga Killers. Here he is, Frank Zappa.
Hiya, kids. How are ya? It's just wonderful that you would come back to listen to me one more time. I'd like to tell you that here at Studio Z, we're doing some wonderful, exciting things nowadays. We're in the process of... why are you feeding me back through there, Bobby, baby? We're in the process of preparing for the, CBS. That's a network that they have, you know, the one that doesn't show many color shows. We're preparing the world's first rock and roll teenage opera for them. And this is no fooling, kids. They're even going to pay us to do it. And the name of this little show, which will probably be on sometime around Valentine's Day, is called I Was a Teenage Malt Shop. And it's really wonderful. It's got a lot of fun songs in it, one of which you'll hear a little bit later. You'll have a lot of fun with it. But what I wanted to say was that this thing could start a new trend, you know, like there used to be those movies, you know, I Was a Teenage Frankenstein and I Was a Teenage Werewolf and all that. But we got some really wonderful stuff to follow up the malt shop with. Let's see, here are some of the wonderful things we can do. Like the following month, we can do I Was a Teenage Lord of the Jungle. A 13-year-old boy is Lord of the Jungle. He talks to animals and they talk to him. Follow him as he searches the dark interior of Africa to find a strange herb that will make hair grow on his chest. That's a good one. And then I Was a Teenage Hubcap. Unwholesome youth mob with long, greasy hair gain control of a small, isolated town and run it better than the fat real estate operators who had it before. That sounds like fun. And then, of course, we have I Was a Teenage Martian. Small town boy reigns in terror over local residents who don't understand him. He falls in love with a plastic girl full of dynamite and computers that the high school metal shop teacher builds as a decoy. They get married and take off for Mars in his flying saucer and it blows up. Then we have I Was a Teenage Gas Station Attendant. A young boy hates his life. He wishes he was a girl. The high school counselor helps him to see that this is only a way of expressing his resentment for the fact that most girls don't like to run a gas pump. Finally convinced that it is not only ridiculous, but expensive, of course, to become a girl, he attempts suicide. At the last minute, his alcoholic mother yells up to him on the bridge, you know, where he's going to jump from, and tells him that he got a scholarship to Juilliard. He comes down and finds out that the letter wasn't for him at all, so he joins the Marines. Then, of course, we have I Was a Teenage Rhinoceros. A psychotic teenage liar's nose keeps growing. His friends reject him. He gets a part in an American International monster movie, his big chance. At the premiere, he tells Hedda Hopper the picture is lousy and his nose goes back to normal. His friends reject him. I Was a Teenage Amoeba, a little animated thing, you know, showing teen life in Pollard's Slough. An educational way to present raw sex among one-celled animals. Here's a wonderful one. I Was a Teenage Artichoke. There is a slumber party. The girls are having merry fun and drinking Pepsis and hitting each other with pillows and making screwy phone calls. And they just get to sleep when one girl wakes up screaming for some strange reason. She finds artichoke leaves are growing out of her arms and head. And then everybody wakes up and tries to decide if they still want to have her for a girlfriend. Pretty soon, they forget about her and start hitting each other with pillows and making screwy phone calls again. Oh, here is a wonderful one. I Was a Teenage Escape Artist. The unusual story of a boy who is kept in a cage in a trailer by his emotionally disturbed parents. One day, he finds a way to escape. Once he is free, he runs away and rents a dog costume. He comes back to the trailer and overhears his parents talking. They believe he's dead. He barks. They come to the door and see him. They really believe he is a dog. They love him and feed him and adopt him and care for him for a long time. Then, one day, the man from the costume shop finally finds him, and he gets arrested because he can't pay for all the rent he owes on the costume, and it's all worn out at the knees, and they have to throw it away. The night they lock him up, there's an earthquake, and he escapes from jail. It is the middle of the night, and it is cold outside, and everybody is all hysterical about the earthquake, so he runs away and joins a circus and becomes a clown. Ooh, and here is one final one. It's a pretty wonderful one. I Was a Teenage Garbage Collector. Their son wants to be a garbage collector, and there's nothing they can do about it. The neighbors are talking, they get mysterious phone calls in the middle of the night, and the guy on the other end hangs up. Still, the youth's mind cannot be changed. He has an overwhelming sense of civic obligation and duty.
He says, who else is going to pick it up? You want to just let it lay there? Today's youth must prepare for tomorrow's challenges, etc. And that's what he'd say all the time. They buy him a new car, new clothes, kiss him when he gets home from school, raise his allowance, take out a policy so he can go to Harvard, buy him a carton of cigarettes and a jar of tackle, and still he wants to be a garbage collector. A wise neighbor suggests the use of negative psychology. Tell him he can do it, and he won't want to. They tell him he can be a garbage collector, he can do anything he wants, and good parents shouldn't stand in the way of their children. Well, the boy and his older sister both become garbage collectors, and the parents move to another city. That's in the near future, friends. We'll be preparing those for some unknown network. Now, I'd like to entertain you musically a little bit, tell you a little bit about, I was a teenage malt shop, and this actually is for real. We're just wonderful up here at Studio Z. They do such strange and crazy funny things. This show, the basic plot of it is there's this this girl and her father, strange relationship they have, and the father owns a little recording studio, and the landlord wants to close the recording studio down and convert it into a malt shop because the girl, her name is Nelda, because her father hasn't had a hit in 3 years. So the story opens up in the recording studio, and the first song of the program is a little ditty that is sung by a very bad rock and roll group called, well, we won't divulge their names yet, but the name of the song is Sharva, I Love You, and I Don't Know What in the World to Do About It. And we've already recorded this thing. Oh, and it's just a dandy song. And I'd like to show you how we do these things here at Studio Z. It's done on our 5-track recording machine. We make multiple recordings here. It's very exciting. This is what the drums for the song sound like. Wail, Bobby. See, we record that all by itself. See, that's the drum part, you know, we put that in. And the next thing we add would be like a little rinkety-tinkety piano on there. Exciting, isn't it, the way these things are done? Oh, boy. And then we put in, you know, like some background singers. And we blend it all just right. What, just right means silence? Well, anyway, there is another way that you can listen to Sharva, I Love You, and I Don't Know What in the World to Do About It. I think we should, like, play the whole thing for you. It's just a dandy song. We'll splice it in right here. Well, I have to do it with... Oh, here it is. Hiya, I'm back again. Oh, boy, I bet you're really glad. Now, I thought I'd entertain you further, seeing as how this is the total entertainment show. I'm going to perform on the guitar for you. I'm going to play some old-time nasty blues for you. Thank you.
That was kind of nice, and it was fun to do, too. I bet you thought I couldn't play that kind of stuff. I mainly just specialize in piano and play that badly, but I can do the same thing on a guitar. Now, I'd like to say that I wish that some of you would write in and say what you think about what you hear on this wonderful two-hour program that begins at 11 o'clock and ends at 1 o'clock on Saturday nights on KSBC, 88.7 on your dial, folks, on the FM dial. Mm-hmm. And I wish you'd write in and say how you like it and how you are today, and just tell me how many kittens that your animals have been having and things like that, and all the important things that you're worried about during the rest of the week that we take care of for you here on Saturday nights. And I'd be very interested in hearing from you if you just address your mail to KSPC, Pomona College, Claremont, California. And you might put my name on there someplace, Uncle Frankie. And good night, folks.